All right, there we go. Okay, welcome everybody to Coffee and Art in the Morning. I'm Dede. It's Wednesday. I don't stream every Wednesday, but most Wednesdays I stream 9 a.m. Eastern. Monday morning is my usual stream time, 9 a.m. Eastern, Monday mornings. And I usually stream a Wednesday, once in a blue moon, a Friday. But anyway, so we're going to work on making some more art cards today. So we're just talking before I hit record about the different sizes. Got to have something here to focus. About the difference between ATC size and the art cards I make. Now, an art card can be any size you want. I make 3x4s and 4x6, but an ATC, as you can see here, is 2.5 by 3.5, just to make the distinction between the two sizes. So you can see an ATC artist trading card, 2.5 by 3.5. And here's the size of art cards I make. Now I'm kind of zoomed out right now, and that's because I'm going to flip through a bunch more of deconstructed journals. I did that, I think it was last week. Anyway, hey, thanks everybody for popping in. If I miss saying hi to you, I try to say good morning to everybody before I hit record. So I see a whole bunch more people coming in. Thanks everybody for being here. And so I'm going to make some more art cards today. I don't know if I'll start some of them. I might, well, I'll probably start you with the deconstructed art journal cutups like I did last week. Most of the time I just start with a blank 3x4 card. But sometimes I'll use leftover journals that I cut up. No, I won't be streaming on Friday. I can't this Friday. Yeah, sorry guys. Yeah, can't stream on Friday. Anyway, so yeah, if y'all have any questions, put them in caps. And if you're watching this recording, hopefully uploaded to YouTube with no problems. I still have one video on part two. Part two of working in the rainforest color book. It's still hung up in Ustream, so we'll see. Anyway, so if you have a question, put it in caps. And again, if you're watching this recording, it's a live show with live people, a live chat. So I'm talking to people in the chat. So I'm not just talking to myself. and yeah, so that's the difference in sizes. And so first though, I'm gonna get out some of the old journals. I gotta have something for the camera to focus on here. And I have a glare for some reason. There we go. There we go. I'm gonna cut up some old journal pages. Old, some of my journals that I've taken apart, deconstructed. And not every page I wanna cut up. Some of them are actual finished collage pieces. But I've got probably another foot and a half of old journal pages that I'm going to flip through, and I'm going to pull some out to cut up and make some art cards. So if y'all have any questions, just ask. All right, so let me gather. I don't have any idea what's in here. I don't have any idea what's in here, but we're going to flip through some of this. We're gonna flip through this. I don't know if we'll get through all of it, but we're gonna start. All right, I'm gonna have to figure out a way to. Let's see, that's gonna put a glare. That's not gonna work. I have to go this way. Welcome, kangaroo babe. Yeah, we have quite a few people from Australia, actually. So let me make this into two stacks. I see some collage stuff right there that I know I'm not going to cut up. So thanks everybody for being here. All right, so I got to keep something here to focus, and then we'll just kind of do a flip through right here, and we'll see what we want to cut up. All right, yeah, it's probably well, yeah, we'll probably do the rest of the hour just doing a flip. And then I'll do another segment with art cards, and we'll see how long it takes. So, all right, so let's see here. And they're all in different stages. I mean, I have different art, these are like deconstructed, like this has these have come out of journals. So they might have something started on the back and then more of a full page on the front, like this, see? So it just, you know, now I'm going to separate collage, finished collages like this that I might want to not cut up from things that I, like these. These I can cut up, right? So these will be good to cut up. Hey, Lindsay Whimsy. So I'm going to make a separate stack. Let me move these cards out of the way so they don't get lost in the shuffle. I'll put the ones we're going to cut up right here. And I have all just different kinds of stuff. Okay, see, like this one, I'm not going to cut up. This one, I can cut up. So I'm just going to kind of flip through here. These are good for cut up. Because I got so much, I need to use it. I need to use it. See, these are starts of collages over the years. I mean, because, you know, I've been streaming for 6 years, even though I've only been uploading to YouTube for like 2 years. But, so those can get cut up. This can get cut up. And when I cut them up, I can be selective. I can, you know, be selective of where I want to cut up. See, there starts of collages in different art journal projects. Don't even ask me what we were doing at the time. Hey, CB, no telling what we were doing at the time. But we're going to use them for art cards. And you can pick a side here. I don't know if it could go either way. Kind of like this one. So, yeah, I'm just going to take a little bit of time to go through these and cut them and decide what I want to cut up. This one would make a nice full-on collage. This one, I'm going to hold on to this one because both of these I could turn into something really cool. Same for this one. If I cut her up, it's going to be kind of... This has got a little stamping. So if you're just joining us, I'm going through some old journal, deconstructed journal pages to cut up. There's tons of them. I mean, there's over a foot. This one would be a good a collage too, but it'd also be good. We'll cut it up. I probably won't get back to it. And I probably won't get time to cut all these up either. Because it's, you know, there's a lot. There's a lot. Okay. I like this one for a full-on collage too. But nah, we'll cut it up. I like that one to cut up though. We might be using this one today. Sorry for the glare, guys, if you have a glare or a flash out. I'm just going through, all the bits here. And again, I have no idea what we were doing when we played with these. Oh, I like that right there. It's like a mask. I try to look at both sides because I might like part of one and part of another. So. I've already got enough here. I've got enough here, plenty here for the, two or three shows. But I'm going to go ahead and start separating them out because they're just stacked up. They are piled up, guys, and I need to use them. If you have any questions, put them in caps. All kinds of projects. We've done a lot of projects. Okay, this one, this was a demo we did on light. Yeah, this was one we did on light. I'll keep this. That was a demo. Now I'm getting into, here's a stack of collages that might be finished, so I won't be cutting these up. Some of these are actually on my slideshow on Ustream. I need to change them out. These are from 2011, and I still have some of these on my Ustream slideshow. When you log into my channel, if I'm not live, I have a slideshow rolls. And some of these are from that. Like, this is from 2011. Separating, haven't they? No, I have another pile. I have one pile over here on the right, and the pile here in front of me, that this is the cut-up pile. That's the cut-up pile, and the keep pile is over there. Like, this is a keep. These are some that I've finished. And again, they're on my slideshow. Sorry, they're flashed out a little, guys, but I didn't want to get the camera too dark. But there's the true color. See, it flashes out. This one's not done, but for some reason, not planned for that one. So I'm saving those. This one is kind of in between, but I could probably do something with that one. This one, nah, I don't, it's too much. I don't like the turquoises too much. Same for this one. This one I'll work on. Your hands are so fast, I didn't notice. Oh, we'll be here all day, Jean. We're going to be here all day if I don't get crack-a-lacking. Seriously. See, like this one, I think I'll keep this one to work on. I like that. I like the blue. Same for this one. So these are in stages where I can do something with them. If I think I can do something with them, I will keep them. Because I need to do something with them. This one goes this way. See? So you can see we've done a lot of art journaling over the years. A lot of art journaling over the years. I think I decided I wanted the tree coming down on that one. But, okay. Say it's gonna work on your seat. Okay, Jean. Different stages. But I'm gonna pull these to work on because these are I'm liking them. And I haven't looked at them for so long. So I'm back from 2011. And turn them into full-on pieces. Not loving this one, but it has possibilities. I really like this, and it can go either. Is this one of those that can mirror? Can mirror it, you know, where you can do it both ways. Keep that one. So thanks, guys, for hanging out while I flip through these and decide which ones we want to keep and which ones we want to cut up. Hey, Di. This one was more finished. Same for this one. As you can see, we got tons and tons of... Okay, so that's a stack I want to keep. We got one keeper stack, and then so far that. Okay, I'm just going to keep going, guys. I'm going to keep going because we got lots. Oh, I like that. I forgot about this one with the door. It's a whole little world right there, people. A whole little world. Yeah, this one we finished and varnished. I don't even know why it's in here because varnished, it's finished. But same for this one. That one's on a, this one's on a board. This one's from 2013. We actually did, this is all painted here. This is all paint. We painted in a little castle. Again, that one's done. Thanks, guys, for just hanging. Okay, this is bothering me. It's kind of in my way. We have something here. There we go. My Sherry card maybe is enough. Keep the light focused. Thanks, Terry. Most of these looks like they're from 2013. And again, a lot of them are on my slideshow because I haven't changed my slideshow. Okay, maybe I do have to have him back a little bit because the light keeps wanting to flash out. Let's see if that'll help. It takes, I mean, we've been doing it a long time. We've been streaming a long time. So yeah, if you're just joining us, I'm picking out things I want to keep and things I want to cut up. I loved her. I had her zipping through time. And they're all in different stages. Like this one, this will be a good one to cut up. I like these colors. I might save that one, and I might save this one. I mean, I seem to have gotten in a little stack of kind of finished stack, or well, not completely finished, but more finished than not. Okay, so here's some like doodling in. Now these are, I don't want all these patterns in my what do you call it? Here's where I drew. I hand drew all the icons. This is in one of my journals that I took it out. I think you should just make a book out of these pages. I hand drew all the logos that I'm in. That'll just be a separate stack. Okay, so let's see here. This one goes this way. I like that. See, I'm liking so many of them. All right, here's some ones that would be good to cut up. I think these are jelly prints. That's pretty. That would be a good art card there. Some of these are some jelly prints stuck in here with stencils. Stencils and jelly prints. Now these, I don't want to start on a pattern like this. I don't mind something like this. That can go in the cut up, but I don't want this. Same for this. That's a good starter. And this is a good starter, but I don't want to start with these. So that will just go in a, I don't know what pile. See, these are all jelly printed. Sorry, your keyboard stuck. I want to try out art collage books. You mean like make a whole book of collages? Oh, we've done that too. Now, if you want to do a full-on sketchbook full of collages, now it takes a while. See, I don't want to use this. Some have too many exact patterns I don't want to use. Something like this might be good, though. And again, I'm not going to get to cut all these up today. But I do want to cut them up into either 4x6 or 3x4. All these. Jelly prints. Hey, Angie Bell. Okay, so I'm not sure what we did with this was cutting out some die cut. This is another one that would be good to cut up. Cut up. Cut up. All these. See, I don't even know what we were doing with these. Some of these might just be leftovers where we were, you know, inking something or spraying something. Well, you could start. This stack has only taken me since 2013. This is a 3-year stack. I mean, we got more, but, you know. Okay, so these, for whatever reason, we glued on old advertisement, but I don't want to use that. Let's see. I'm just looking for stuff like this. Again, not loving these colors. I mean, some of these are kind of dull colors. I don't really love these colors. Love this one. It's got some hearts on it. Again, jelly plate papers. Here's one where we did some die cut and then jelly plated on them. Here's another collage piece. No, I have a cameo silhouette. I do have quite a few stencils that I bought too. But like this right here, this is from a cameo cutout. Right here. The die cuts. You can put those on a jelly plate. So let's see what we got here left in this stack. And then we still have this stack. So this hour or 45 minutes is just going to be going through all this. Okay, and deciding whether I want to keep it for, this can get kind of, some of them are double-sided, so you got to kind of pick which side you like the best. Or you can pick a bit of one and a bit of another. Those can get cut up. Let me get this stack right here. These are all deconstructed art journals. I'll reuse art journals, or if I need a cover for something, I'll just cut them up. Okay, I like that sign. So they're all in, these are all, most of these that I'm flipping through here are in process. This one was a, this is a two, I was going to say, I thought this was a two-pager. Can't remember. I think it went this way. No, it went this way. This was a two-page collage piece there. And then this one was going to go with this one, but I'm not going to finish that one. So I'll hold these. And then we'll cut up this one if there's nothing on the back I want to keep. Yeah, Angelina. Do you want to cut this one up? I don't know. I might want to do something with her. This one, oh, again, here's a two-parter. These are old, guys. Old, I tell you. I think these can get cut up. I like both sides, but okay, we'll put that like that can get cut. If y'all have any questions, put them in caps. I'm just flipping through art journal pages to reuse. I want to keep this because here's the reason I want to keep this. This, we actually saw these little sea dragons. They're not like seahorses. They're like sea dragons at the Atlanta Aquarium. So I want to keep him just because it reminds me of when I was there. Cut up. Cut up. Cut up. Bits of that, bits of this. Okay. This was a sample something we did on the show. I don't even remember. Cut up. This was a two-parter, I think. This has got texture paste on it. I don't use much texture paste, but we did some texture paste with a stencil on this one. This was a good sample page, so I'll keep that for my sample page. Let's get another stack here. How many cards are you... Yeah, how many can I cut from one page? It depends. Like on this, and again, this one's got texture paste on it too, so I probably don't want to do a collage on it. You know, if I want to do a 4x6 or 2 3x4s, you can get like maybe one, a couple of big ones and 3 or 4, or 1 2 3 4 5, yeah, 6 or 8, you know, depending on what size. Yeah, I'll keep that one out because it's got texture paste on it. I don't want to use that on art cards. Now this will be an awesome one to use. More. See, some of these are just, I don't even remember, guys. We've done so many projects over the years, you know? But these can all get cut up. Cut up, cut up. Bit of the Last Supper in there. I don't know what we were doing. You're at the Tampa Aquarium. Yeah, we do too. I loved them. Me and Cam took our sketchbooks and we drew that, those guys. So all this can get cut up. Again, these are all bits of deconstructed journals and or collage pages, which the collage pages that are finished or not, or that I want to use. Now this would be a good one. That'll be a good collage page if I finish that. I'll cut that one. I'll keep that one. So, same for this one. I can see a lot of possibilities in that, baby. Set that one aside. This one, well, I think I planned on doing a cave. I'll set that one aside. This one we can cut up. Cut up. And this one, too, I want to do a cave world in that one. I think I must have had cave day or something. How to make caves, cave worlds. Oh, this one we did a, that was a project. I forget what the thing, anyway, that was a specific project. Again, with the texture paste, you can't really glue things on top of texture paste, so I won't be using this. Hey, Vicky S., anybody else popping in? This was the side, the double page spread. This one, same thing, texture paste. This one we can cut up. This one we can cut up. Again, I'm not going to do all these today, guys, obviously. Look how many I've already got to cut up. But I'm separating them out. I'm pulling out the ones I want to keep from the ones I want to cut up so I don't have to. Now, that one might be a good collage. I think I'll keep that one. Cut that one up. So, yeah. So, we've done a lot of stuff over the years. That's napkin right there. This is a napkin start thing. This one is in process. This one will be a good one to finish. Another one to finish. Okay, so let's see what we got so far. All right, so this is the keep pile. There's the keep pile so far. And even though these I'm not going to use in cutting up, they're still discards. So I'll just put those on the bottom. These are our cut ups so far. All right, let's go. Look, we still have this much to go through. This is not even all my stuff, guys. This is just a stack I came across. This was a sketch. This was an actual sketchbook we did some animal sketches in. I mean, like some quick sketches. Let's see what we got here. Now, these I'm not going to cut up for art cards, obviously, but hedgehog. Just all kinds of, I think we were doing quick sketches this day. So, little animal sketches. I need to cut the spiral thing off because it can catch. But I think we did some of these for ideas. Yeah, some of these are ideas from my, what do you call it? My fantasy animal posters. Maybe these were the sketches for those. I don't know. Okay, so that'll go in a separate pile too. Some little bunnies. These aren't that old. These are from 2014. Some little card sketches. All right, let's go back to the next pile here. There's no rhyme or reason. Oh, this we did a thing on Pennsylvania. I forgot what it was for, but we did. This is the history of Pennsylvania. I read this before. Maybe I'll set that aside and read that. I don't know if we'll get to it today, but I'll set that aside and reread that. Here's a good one for cutting up. Drew some eyes. I don't know where we were going with this, but drew the eyes on top of, you know, but yeah, here's some more. Okay, I'll keep that one, but this one I don't need. We'll cut that up. Ostrich, yeah, those are some old ones. Here's another old one, a little cat. This is from 2012. Again, some of these are probably for animal posters. There's a frog thing. I like this though for an art card. I'm just kind of flipping back and forth, deciding which side I might want to cut up. Start of a collage. I like that. I like her. Most days. Oh, yeah. These were done with dilution spray. So, again, let me wet my finger here and let's just see if they still smear. Yeah, they'll still. See, even after however long, they're not water, you know, they're not waterproof. This one was done on wax paper. I don't know, but I don't want to cut that. You know, that won't work. Art card. Here's one of my stamps. Okay, here's some more stuff to cut up. That's a good one to cut up. That's a good one to cut up. Hope y'all can see. I'm going quick, guys. I'm breezing through these babies. so we can decide some of these. Do you have any questions? Put them in caps. I don't know what you could be asking right now, but we're doing flip throughs, bits of art journals. Here's one of my stamps. That's a gargoyle stamp I carved. This is one of the wheel stamps I carved. Again, I don't want to use this kind of stuff on my art cards. It's too defining. I like things that you can redo and not have a definitive. Used a little stamp there. Oh, but Rach would be proud there. I used a little ruler stamp. Yeah, dilution sprays. Yeah, they move. They will move. One of my hand-carved cupcake stamps right there. But we can use that side. All this can be cut up. For this, this right here, I want to keep this because this reminds me of, I think it's Servo on Mystery Science 3000. All right. Oh, this can get cut up. That can be cut out. Okay, let's keep moving. We're going to get through this stack, guys. We are getting through it. All right, let's see what else we got here. I have no idea what we're going through. Okay, this was a couple of, I think it went this way. This was a double page spread. I really like her. She's, it's the same girl, a model. And really thought she is gorgeous. I'm not cutting her up because she's so pretty. So pretty. We can put a fork, stick a fork in it, you're done. A door. No, let's go this way with the door. I'll maybe use that one. Again. Put up my first collage art journal vid on YouTube. Oh, okay. Post links should be open. If they're not, one of the girls will open them for you. Put your link in there. That's a napkin right there. I like this. I mean, bits of this. See, bits of this can be a good collage. I'm really liking that one. I'll pull that one. Bits of these can be cut into art cards. You know, your art journal pages, if you don't like your art journal pages or you just happen to do a lot of them and you're not using them, cut them up. Cut them up for, okay, this was a napkin journal page here. That was a double page spread there. Although I'm really liking to cut that up. I think I'll cut that one up and keep this side. I'll keep that one. Okay, let's see. So you can really reuse things, guys. She was a work in progress, and then this was a finished, more of a finished collage here. I'm putting the more fin, you know, something I can either finish, or this was a double page spread, I think. Yeah, that was a double page. Little dog. Some other things here. We'll use that, but yeah, napkin journal. Okay, this one. Oh, this was a double. This is one of those reversibles. So you can go either way. Go this way, see the tree, or it can go this way. I'll keep that one. This is one of my, I love this one. I actually made a print of this and have it framed in my house. This is from 2012. I love this one. I just like the whole thing about it. I don't know, but that's my original there. Yeah, some of these I've, yeah, these are from 2012. We did these on streams years ago. So I'm not going to cut those up. She's not finished. I'll cut her up. I'll cut that up. This one I like. I'm not done with it, but I like it. All right, let's see what else we got in here. This was a piece of clip art. All right, let's turn this back over here. Here we go. Oh, this is a good one to cut up. Ooh, I like this. I'm liking that one. That's a good one to cut up. Okay, we'll set that one right there. I mean, some of them just strike me quicker than other ones to make cards out of. So you can see I'm never going to run out of stuff to make art cards with. Am I? I like this. This one's not even glued down yet. All right, let's see. Cut up. Cut up. Cut up. These are napkins right there. Napkin on there. This would be a good one though for a 4x6. Fun seeing some of these old collages. Yeah, because Julie would have been around back in these days doing these babies. I like that and some of that. I like both sides. Some of them I like both sides. We can cut them up. You know? More napkin bits. This one's not glued down yet. Again, I think this was some leftover where we sprayed some die cuts. This is a print of one of my collages. So these are prints. I'm not going to leave those. Got a stack of those. Let's pull those out. Okay. Napkin journal page. Oh, I remember this one. This one's from 2010. It goes this way. Does it go? No, it goes this way. Yeah. Okay. Napkin bit. Napkin. No, not napkin. Might use her for something. Okay, next stack. We're getting through it, guys. I just thought it would be fun to flip through so you can see what I cut up. I mean, I got so much of this stuff. I mean, this is nothing. I've got shelves and shelves and shelves of art journal pages. All right, let's go through this last stack. I'm having fun anyway. Okay, cut up. It's got some doodles on it. Cut up and doodles. I don't, that is not even going to be anything. All right, let's see. Some more. Those are good for collage cut ups. As you can see, it's not like we're gonna run out. If you like it, okay, thanks, Lynn. Yeah, I don't know. I enjoyed looking through other people's, you know, other people's journal pages. It's just that the mine's deconstructed. They're not in. I have tons of them in journals too, but I have a lot of them that are loose because I've deconstructed the journal. Right? She would be. That would be a good finish to finish. Let's see what else here. This was one that we worked on. I used this one. I made art cards out of this actually, printed ones. That's the other half. So put those together. This was in stage. We'll finish that one eventually. Some of these I might want to finish. Probably not that one. I do like this one. I think I'll keep that one. Nah, I'm not going to keep it. I'll cut it up and make art cards out of it. That's so pretty. Love that. Okay. So all different stages. I love these with the coral and the fish. Maybe I'll pull that one and this one. We'll use those today. I mean, because I'm only going to make 8 cards. I'm only going to make probably 8 to 10 cards, guys. That's funny, isn't it? All this for 8 to 10 cards. But this is how my collages start out. You've seen them in my Delusions journals. The finished ones, this is how they all start. They all start like this. So some days I'm in a mood to glue, so I'll just glue a whole bunch, you know? And I like that too. I think we'll use that one. More fish. I like that. That'll be a good art card. And some of them I might make some 4x6 and I might make some 3x4s. We'll see. Lionfish. Ooh, that'll be a good one. Needs to be bigger though than a 4x6. We'll hold off on that one. Like this door. This is a good one to finish someday. I think I'll hold off on that one. Here's my lion door knocker. I'll hold off on that one. This has just got some bits on it. Cut-ups. Dee, you might have enough for 8 cards. Yeah, I think. Okay, let's get another stack here. Oh, I got some file folders in here. Don't know why. We're not at the end. I'll save that for the very last one. I'll show that. Okay, so I got a bunch of leftover. These are all craft. See, I'm always looking for file folders, and here's a big stack of them. I probably went out and bought file folders since. But here's a stack of file folders. Let's separate those out. This was just a little collage on a board. We're not going to cut that up. Okay, what else do I have in here? So these are just some Delusions. Okay, these were sent to me by somebody. Who are these from? These are Canson canvas paper with golden acrylics and kosher salt. So these were sent to me by somebody. There's 4 of them here. Need to do a giveaway or something with those. All right, let's put those to the side. Here's some different. I don't very rarely put words, but I think somebody asked me to, and half of them are falling off. It's my bluebird of happiness. This was my bluebird of happiness. Okay. Here's a little monk. Again, not done. Oh, here is, and I did send him a print. This was, I did an Oasis studio for Blade and his family. I need to send that to him. This is old. When did I do this? That's not even on there. 2013, maybe? I'll pull that out. Okay, here's some more stuff. This would be a good one to finish. Oh, wait, there's something finished on the back. We'll set that one aside. Yeah, this is a good one to cut up. Another good one to cut. Oh, look, these are some good ones in here. Some nice, colorful ones. Good cut-ups. Oh, yes. Oh, look at this one. This will be great. I'll put that one for a definite cut-up. This was in some kind of stage. That'll be a good one to cut up. I keep saying that over and over. You like the Oasis? Yeah, that was a Blade, you know, artistic biker. Yeah. His family. This is a good one to cut up. This is a work. I want to keep this one. If they're like over 50% done, I'll keep them and maybe sometime do something with them. I'm going to do that one. Okay. Again, not sure. Some of these are. There's a little stamp girl. That's a stamped thing. I got a few things here. This is one of my butterfly. I gave the butterfly stamp away. I forget who I gave it to. But this was one of my hand-carved butterfly stamps. And I did, you know, different color versions of it. You didn't date. I know. It was probably because it was in my art journal, Jean. It was in an art journal that was dated. Look. Here's the cover. So anyway, this is one of my hand carved butterfly. I actually gave that carved stamp away, but I don't remember who I gave it to. But yeah. This was some die cuts. Silhouette die cuts, and we use the shiny paint per Jean, I'm sure. But these were these are silhouette die cuts used as masks. So we got a few of those. We'll set that aside. Let's see here. Let's put put this on the bottom of the stack. Kind of keeps it sturdy. I got cut up, I don't know, some kind of face sketch on there. I have no clue. No clue on some of these guys, seriously. Let's just put a little face in a watch. Scraped off paint. Those make, these are all, you wouldn't be surprised. Well, we did some last time. With scraped off paint, they make great landscapes. Here's another one. See, even if I just cut out this and don't save the rest, it doesn't bother me at all because I'm reusing them. Finally found the back of the, yeah, but we still have this much more to go. All right, so let's see. Yeah, I'm not going to use that one. Okay. Let's see what else. Oh, here's some more of my butterfly stamps. Just stamped out. Oh, I got to stack them. I guess because I gave it away. I said, well, I need to stamp out a whole bunch of those babies. These need to go with my stamps. Not in this stack. I'm added one. Okay, so let's put that. Okay, this is just some doodles here. Goes over there. A little. Yeah, I'm not much for Zentangling, but I did do a little doodly fish. I guess that's just a doodle fish. It wouldn't really be a Zentangle. Another little bird there. Okay, let's put these over here. I have no idea. This is from 2011. I have no idea some of these things. Here's just a bird. There's, you know, collages in different stages. This looks like a front and back of a journal. So we'll keep those. Again, more bits of photo collage. This is texture paste through the stencil, through one of the, same for those owls. These are all texture pasted. Okay, what do we got? Some addresses. Don't want to show that. I don't know what. This was one of my envelopes where we did animals. I wanted to practice doing some little charcoal something. So we took one of these calendar pages and started doing a little charcoal drawing on it. Oh, this is when we did. Oh, I remember this, guys. Remember when we were doing the vegetable thing, we were drawing vegetables and doing write-ups about it, like a whole little journal of vegetables. Yeah. Okay, I don't know what all this is. That's a good one to cut up. That's a good one to cut up too. Again, not sure where we're going with that. Another there's a piece of a feather. This one's a more of a finished collage. I'll keep that one. This one can get cut up. This one can get cut up. Cut up. These are old, guys. Now, these are like, I'm thinking 2010. Some of these. This was a little square journal. Obviously, it was a square journal. You like the vegetable strings, Janet? Yeah. We just do a little everything around here, don't we? Yeah. This was a small journal. This is my Mona. I'll keep her just because she's my muse. But these are all just different stages and different things. I really like her too. Although we smeared some paint on her or something. We'll maybe use her. This is on a piece of cardboard. Oh, I think I used it as a cover. That's probably why. All right, we're getting down to the bottom of the stack. We're getting down there. Let's make these small ones its own stack. We do a lot of play around here, don't we? A lot of play. Oh, I like this. There's some good stuff in there. Anytime I see something Egyptian, I think of Linda, art unit. Oh, she's here. Hi, art unit. Another something. Maybe these two will cut that up too. We'll use these. I've already got a stack of stuff ready to pull to cut. Different. journal pages to cut up. These two I had a plan for. I don't remember what, but I think I'll set those two aside. Don't cut them up. Uh-oh, sorry, guys. Let's see. Another bit of, that would be a good one to cut. Maybe we'll cut some out of that. Well, I've already got a stack of it. And let's see. Okay. All right, I think we're done. Let me restack here. Those go in there. All right. Throw these back on the shelf, otherwise I don't have room to move. All right, let's get the keepers over here. And I'll separate the keepers with that hard cover from the ones. These are all for cut-ups now. Look, you think we'll ever run out of stuff to cut up? Here's our cut-ups. All right, guys, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to save this video. I've got a stack right here that I pulled that we're going to make art cards from. So let me save this video, go run, get some hot coffee, and we'll start a new segment to make art cards. So I'll be right back.